pleasure. When we talk about pleasure, we are referring to mental states that we humans experience as positive, enjoyable, or worth thinking. Pleasure includes more specific mental states such as happiness, entertainment, enjoyment, ecstasy, euphoria, and hopefully we all know and we all have experienced pleasure. Now, not every pleasurable experience evokes the same amount of pleasure in each of us. Hashtag my feelings are exclusive. Are you ready to evaluate different experiences according to how much pleasure they make you feel? Hey, you know the routine. I will show you pictures and you tell me how much pleasure the experience in that picture give you from 1 to 10. Remember to be fast. Ready? Go. Chocolate. How much pleasure from 1 to 10? You have it? In my case, it is about a level 5. Sort of. Are you above or below 5? Okay, and what about dancing? That's an average level 6 for me. And for you? Hey, my friend, if you don't know how to dance, I have to recommend a trip to Cuba, Colombia, Argentina, or Brazil, but you have to experience dancing. Ready for another one? Parental care. Do you have that one among your pleasures? I would go with level 7 in this category, but with fluctuations from levels below 5 to plus infinity. You probably agree with me that this one is a very special category. Now, tell me your number for money. This one is a clear case of extrinsic reward. Money is not bringing pleasure by itself, but the pleasurable experience can be conditioned in each of us. What is your level for this one? In my case, and maybe because I haven't had too much luck in that department, I still have it at a level 8 or so. One more, sex. You know, not biological sex like in our last video, the other sex. Come on, shout the number. On this side, that's a 9 for sure. Last slide, now think about what a level 10 pleasurable experience for you could be. Something above all the others. I bet that one is not easy to find. A level 10? Well, come closer. I may be able to explain to you how is it that certain illegal drugs like cocaine will give you a level 10 pleasure. You heard me right, a level 10, baby. I can't explain that right now. But if I beg you to stay with me, is because I also can, I also wish, and I also feel the need to explain to you how is it that at the same time cocaine is giving you a level 10 pleasure, in a moment, it is also stealing from you all your pleasures in the future. From the tens to the ones. You need to know, and you need your loved ones to know. This time, I don't invite you. I beg you to stay with me. Our W today is where, and our question, where does cocaine steal our pleasure? And before I tell you what I know about it, let's put our disclaimers out of the way. Number one, we have no time to go in depth, but we hope to give you enough information for you to have an educated neuroscientific position in relation to cocaine and other illegal drugs. Number two, please find relevant links in the description below, which we always encourage you to check. And number three is from Bobby. Hey, Bobby, you told me you have some disclaimer for our friends. My friend Bobby, everybody. There you have it, guys, a fair disclaimer. Thank you, Bobby. Now I am ready to jump into some explanations about the workings of the brain. If someone tells you to understand something about behavioral neuroscience, you probably need a PhD. You need to know that's not true. This is straightforward stuff for anybody interested in understanding how our brain works. This is easy for you. You stay with me and I promise you will get the full picture about how cocaine tricks our brain. Here we go. For humans to experience pleasure, we need areas responsible for pleasure in our brain. One of those areas, here in green, is the nucleus accumbens. When the neurons in the nucleus accumbens are active, we experience pleasure. All these green dots are pleasure neurons. Our pleasure is born right there, and they are activated to give us pleasure by these red neurons here. Now, if you zoom in where red and green neurons meet, you have something like this. I know what you're thinking. This drawing is definitely not from Santiago Ramón y Cajal. I'm sorry, I told you it's not easy to draw like Don Santiago. But focus here in the blue circle. Right there, the red neuron can activate the green pleasure neuron. And that is where cocaine is going to give us level 10 pleasure. You will see how in a minute. If we go with a super zoom into the blue circle around the red-green contact, this is what we see. The red neuron almost touches the green neuron, but not quite. That structure is the synapse. Santiago Ramón y Cajal called the synapses kisses, remember? You have trillions of those in your brain. So much of who we are, what we do, and how we feel happens here, and therefore, we all should know that word. Hashtag synapse, hashtag synapse, hashtag synapse. We are getting there. The synapse is sort of a neuron switch, but you need something to pass the activation from the red neuron to the green pleasure neuron. And that is the pleasure molecule that is contained in these vesicles, the neurotransmitter dopamine. When dopamine is released into the synapse, it will reach the green pleasure neuron and activate it. But for dopamine to activate the mechanisms of pleasure, it will need a receptor on the membrane of the green pleasure neuron, here in purple. When you have dopamine released into the synapse, and that dopamine reaches the dopamine receptors, you will experience pleasure. There you have it. Dopamine, the pleasure molecule, plus dopamine receptors equals pleasure for you and me. Remember number one, the more dopamine, the more pleasure. Remember number two, the more receptors, the more pleasure. Remember number three, the less dopamine, the less pleasure. And remember number four, the less receptors, the less pleasure. You have this. Only one molecule is missing to have a much better picture. The dopamine transporter in the red neuron. That one is essential. Our brain needs to respond again and again to new pleasurable stimuli. And our brain can only do that if it can take all of the dopamine from a previous stimulus out of the synapse. Imagine you bite a chocolate and you feel pleasure. To feel pleasure again with a new bite, you need your brain getting rid of the previous wave of synaptic dopamine. Cocaine is about to jump into the picture. You will see how unfortunately smart that drug is. The dopamine transporter will take dopamine back into the vesicles of the red neuron and make the red neuron ready to release dopamine again if a new pleasurable stimulus reaches the body. If you have the three molecules, dopamine, dopamine receptor, and transporter, you will have green light to experience pleasure. And when the stimulus stops, the pleasure will also stop, as it should. And now comes cocaine. If cocaine is present, it will block the transporter on the red neuron so that dopamine cannot go back and pleasure doesn't stop. You will get more and more dopamine in the synapse, more and more activation of the green neuron, and more pleasure. That is a high. When snorted or injected, cocaine quickly produces an intense rush. It doesn't last more than 30 to 45 minutes, but the pleasure is super powerful. Definitely a level 10 or more. Some will feel it like having high energy and confidence, sort of having superpowers. They could fly, they could fight a lion, they are on top of the world, or so they feel. Up to here, we are referring only to the good part of the cocaine experience. But that super high is not adaptive for our species. Imagine if you try to fly or you try to fight a lion. That will be your end. And during millions of years of evolution, our brains got that very clear. It has to take that level of pleasure down to normal. And our brain does that by down-regulation. The brain will take the dopamine receptors out of the membrane. And now, even if you have a lot of dopamine, you don't feel that much pleasure anymore because you have less receptors. If you want to use cocaine to experience the same high, now you need more cocaine. But that, my friend, is not the worst. The worst is that once you stop using cocaine, you have so few receptors for dopamine that you feel no pleasure with any of the feelings you enjoyed before. Life becomes sad, bitter, worthless for you. Cocaine have stolen your pleasure right in the nucleus accumbens. At this moment, if you want to feel anything joyful again, you need cocaine. That is one of the most dangerous games you can play in life. As the next quote puts it, when you can stop, you don't want to. And when you want to stop, you can't. That's addiction. May I finish with a piece of advice? Please identify the sources of your pleasures in life. The ones who give you the levels 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and enjoy them all. But even if you know now that it is almost for sure to have a level 10 with cocaine, remember that brief pleasure of cocaine could very well represent no pleasure for a long, long time after you use it. Not only for you, but also for many around you. To play safe, you need to avoid cocaine and other illegal drugs only one time. The first one. Life is full of opportunities and sources of clean, legal, and long-lasting pleasure. Find them and bet for them. And even better, write down in the comments which are your preferred sources of natural pleasure. We really appreciate when you share with the rest of us. Dear friends, please stay safe and God bless you.